Hi, my name is Marie Cruz and I'm a Senior Developer Advocate at Grafana Labs. In this beginner-friendly video tutorial, I'll walk you through what heatmaps are and when to use them. By the end of this tutorial, you should also know how to configure a heatmap to visualize your data in Grafana. In one of the previous video tutorials, I spoke about histograms. While histograms look at the value distribution over a specific time range, they don't allow you to see any trends or changes in the value distributions over a period of time. This is where heatmaps can be useful. To understand heatmaps, imagine that you have a table full of numbers. It could be the temperatures recorded for a specific city. What if you want to see the hottest and coolest areas at a glance? A heatmap can take those numbers and turn them into different colors. Hotter areas might be red or orange, while cooler areas might be blue or green. So with a heatmap, you can quickly see where the hotspots are without looking at many numbers. In Grafana, a heatmap is essentially a histogram but represented over time. Each time slice or cell that you see here is a histogram on its own. Instead of using different bars or buckets, a heatmap visualizes your data as different cells, with each of the cells representing different colors to interpret your data's distribution easily. To help you in this tutorial, I'll be using the Grafana test data data source, which comes built in with Grafana and is particularly useful if you are a Grafana beginner. With that explanation out of the way, let's get started. First, I'll add a new visualization to a dashboard, and then I'm going to make sure that the Grafana test data data source is selected. Then I'm going to select the linear bucket heatmap data. Under the visualization dropdown, I'm going to choose heatmap. One thing to note about heatmaps in Grafana is that they work best with time series data. To investigate the underlying time series data for this scenario, let's click Query Inspector followed by Data. Looking at the visualization, the time that you see here are displayed on the x-axis. In contrast, the different columns, which we can imagine for now as the temperature, has been displayed on the y-axis. Each of the values that you see here has been plotted as cells. To customize the heat map, I'm going to add a title first, which I will call temperature. Next, under the heatmap option, there is a setting here called Calculate from Data. This setting determines if the data is already a calculated heatmap from the data source or one that should be calculated in the panel. The linear bucket heatmap data is already a calculated heatmap, so I will leave this option as no. As a recommendation, it's better to do the heatmap calculation during metric collection or store the data in Elasticsearch, Prometheus, or any other data source supporting histogram bucketing on the raw data. To customize the y-axis, I can also add the temperature unit and set it to Fahrenheit. Now, since heatmaps use colors, Grafana provides different color schemes that you can choose from. Under the colors option, you can see different schemes, and for this tutorial, I'm going to select the red scheme. To determine the number of colors to use, you can configure the steps. So for example, if I set this back to 2, you can see that there are only 2 colors displayed in my heat map. As I increase the number of steps, more shades of red appear. Moving over to the cells, if you want to hide specific values, you can provide which values you want to hide. So for example, if I want to hide any 0 or empty values, I can set this option to 0 and I'm going to see it as a gap in my histogram. Since heatmaps are just histograms over time, you also have the option to show the histogram when you hover over any cell. To do so, under the tooltip option, I'm going to toggle the Show Histogram option. Now, when I hover over the cells, I can see how the histograms change over time. I can also toggle the color scale to represent the mapping between the cell value and the color. And there you have it. In this beginner-friendly video tutorial, I've shown you how you can configure a heatmap to visualize your data in Grafana. Check out our documentation if you want to learn more about heatmaps, which you can find in the video description below. I hope you found this video useful, and if you do, please let us know in the comments. And as always, happy visualizing!